Hi guys, welcome to my channel. My name is Elisa. I am feeling really, really happy today. I don't know why. I feel super refreshed. And I wanted to show you guys what I recently bought, mainly from Misguided and Dynamite. And I did buy some things from Bath & Body Works, which I know aren't clothes, but it's worth showing. So I hope you guys enjoy this video and let's get started. I'm gonna try and zip through everything that I got. My son Lincoln is taking a nap right now and I know for a fact that once he wakes up, the video is done. I cannot continue because he's just gonna waltz in here and not let me film. The first couple things I show you guys are my absolute favorites from this order. I'm gonna show you guys Misguided first. I got this cute button-up. Look how adorable this is. I've been looking online everywhere for a good shacket, I believe is what it's called. The definition of a shacket is a shirt slash jacket. I looked on the Aritzia website, I looked on the H&M website, and I didn't see one that I really, really liked. Fortunately though, when I was on Misguided, I found the perfect one. I love the color palette of this jacket. You can see the browns, the neutrals, the blues. The browns and the neutrals obviously are my thing, and the blue is just a cute pop of color. I got really inspired actually by my good friend Katrina. She came by last month to drop off my Christmas present, and her outfit was adorable. She was wearing a button-up underneath a black long coat and she looked adorable, so super inspired by her outfit. I got this one in a size 2, and like I said, it has browns, beige, neutral colors with a pop of blue. Classic button closure, and it has these two pockets in the front, which I probably will not utilize, but hey, it looks good. You never know, I could put some random things in here. I could put snacks in here. The outside of the jacket, it is really soft. However, the inside, not as soft. I don't know what the dealio with that is, but it's still super cute. When I was looking for a jacket, oversized is totally what I was going for, so this is perfect. The next thing that I got is also oversized, and I love, love, love it. It falls in line with my neutral beige brown wardrobe color palette, and it is this really chunky open front cardigan. Chunky is a good thing. It's super warm, super cozy. It has been my go-to sweater since I got it probably. So I wear it on my way to work underneath my winter parka. Even when I'm at home and I'm just in lounge clothes, I wear this over top and it keeps me really, really warm. Online, the color is beige, I believe. In person, it is definitely beige with a little like undertone of blush pink, I think, if my eyes don't deceive me. This one is in the smallest size, 2/4, and yeah, perfect size, really comfortable. Oh, and it's just so soft. Like, I wish you guys could feel this right now. If you go on their website and you end up buying the sweater, you will not regret it, I promise you. Next thing that I got from Misguided is a pair of pants. I am a huge fan of wide leg pants or culottes, and these are freaking adorable. I'm definitely going to be wearing this only at home because it's see-through. Nobody needs to see the undergarments besides my husband. I believe this pair of pants come in different colors. I chose white. A lot of the things that I got, which I will show you, fair warning, a lot of them are white. White, off-white, cream, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, I got this one in white. It is super wide leg. I tried it on. It is so cozy. It is knitted, soft material. It's ribbed. In case you need to tighten it a little bit, there is a drawstring right in the front. But again, if you get white, it's see-through. With the pandemic going on, I live in Manitoba and we were in lockdown or partial lockdown for the past month and a half to 2 months, something like that. I don't even know anymore. I lost track of the time, but we were in partial lockdown. So a lot of my time I've been spending at home, and why not be comfy while you're at home? I have been comfy. I have been comfy in these pants and in the sweater and everything else. Next thing I'm going to show you guys is a coordinate set or cord set, whatever you want to call it. This set here, and it is freaking adorable. Look at this color. So me, right? This set comes with a pair of jogger pants and a cropped sweatshirt. Don't get me wrong, this set is really, really cozy, really comfortable. Like, I've been wearing it a lot since I've gotten it. But because of my body figure though, I'm very petite in size with no butt. With these jogger pants, they fit really well. They sit well on my waist, but because I don't have the booty for it, I think I'm not filling the bottom part very well. What I'm pretty much trying to say here is I don't have a big butt, and when I wear these pants, you can tell. I'm not too tall, I'm not too short, I'm about 5'4", and it does kind of bunch up around my ankles, so just be warned if you're shorter than 5'4", then to go with the shorter length, definitely. I've been wearing this set just while I've been at home. It is still pretty cold outside where I live, so once the weather starts to warm up a little bit, I will very likely be wearing this out with a puffer jacket, very likely, and I don't know, socks over top of my ankles. Yeah, white sneakers. I think that'd be cute. Next is another coordinate set, and it is this set right here. Not jogger pants, but biker shorts. And again, because of my small figure, these fit a little bit funny on me. Still, really cozy. Cozy is what I was going for. I wasn't, you know, trying to show off my booty to anybody. This one has an adjustable drawstring as well. I got this in the dark gray color, and this cropped top is very similar to the crop top that I just showed you guys. However, the bottom is, I think it's called frayed. This is what this one looks like. And the other cropped sweatshirt that I showed you guys, it looks like this on the bottom. So, yeah. Frayed, non-frayed. Frayed, non-frayed. One more thing from Misguided, and it is a purse. Look how cute this is. I believe they called it a camera bag or camera purse, something like that. I'm not really in touch with my fashion terms, but I believe that's what it was called, a camera bag. And I love this. It has a chevron pattern in the front. Pretty spacious actually inside. When I'm not going to work and I'm just out and about, all I need really are my cell phone, license, debit card, credit card, lip balm, eyelash glue, and that's pretty much all that I need. So this bag is the perfect size for me. The hardware is gold and it has the leather strap here. The strap on this is not adjustable, so when I wear it, it sits probably right at my waist, which is what I like. Right here. Super cute. That was everything from Misguided. Next is Dynamite. They were having a Boxing Week sale, so I took full advantage of it. I think a lot of the things that I got were $7, $10, something like that, with a couple of things I got at regular price, but they are hella cute, so it's totally worth it. So this is the first top that I got from Dynamite. Seeing it in person, I'm not too crazy about it, but it's still really cute. I think it'll go really well with what I wear in the summertime, definitely. It is an off-white color. The shoulders have shoulder pads on here, and I don't think I've ever had a top actually that had shoulder pads in it. It's sleeveless, obviously, as you can see. I got it in an extra small. Actually, everything that I got is in an extra small, just putting it out there. And I don't know if it's because of how it arrived in the package, but it just seems like it's gonna wrinkle easily, so we'll see. It says on the tag $10, but I know for a fact I got it for $7, so pretty sweet for a $7 top. So next is a basic white short sleeve top. The material on this is like really, really soft. I think it's great quality. This one for sure I got for $7. It is a scoop neck, which I was pretty nervous about actually when I was searching or when I was shopping online for these shirts. When they are a V-neck, they go really low on me and I have a smaller chest, so sometimes just don't like it. But this one though, surprisingly, it fits really, really well. I think that's pretty much all I have to say about this top. It's basic, it's white, it's a good top. When I'm shopping, I always go for the basics because they pretty much go with everything. Like a basic white top, it can go with black pants, it can go with blue jeans, it could go with ripped jeans, it could go with, I don't know, anything. Another white top. This one is ribbed and it has a puffy sleeve or puffer sleeve, and it reminds me of these tops that Dynamite used to have like years ago. I had it in pink and black, and when I saw this online, it just totally reminded me of those tops, so I ended up getting it. This one I believe was $10, $8 to $10, I can't remember. But yeah, good shirt if you're like working in an office, you know, semi-cash. Another white top. This one is also ribbed, short sleeve. It is a crew neckline. And this one on the tag, it says $12. Pretty sure, again, I got it for like $8 to $10-ish. On the tag, it says off-white, but this looks pretty white to me. Good top. surprise, surprise, another off-white shirt. This one is long sleeve though. I believe this was called a bodycon long sleeve. It is ribbed, but it also has some fancy stitching in the front. The material on this is pretty thin and it is see-through, just so you know. So be careful on what you wear underneath. Be mindful if you're wearing a nude bra, I think that would be fine, but yeah, anything bright, no. And when I say lightweight, I mean lightweight. I was trying that on and I could feel the cold. Yay, not a white or off-white top. This one is pretty similar to the top that I just showed you. It's long sleeve. The material on it is very, very similar. It's gray, so not as see-through, but you still want to be careful of which bra you wear underneath. Same as the other shirt, I should have gotten a small in this, so whatever size that you normally fit, you would probably go a size up with this shirt. All of those items were part of Dynamite's Boxing Week sale, totally worth the price. I want to say that most, if not all of these items are still available on their website. Last time I checked, I think they were having an extra 40% off of their sale items. So anything that's available, I'm still going to link it down below. The next couple of things though, definitely still available, but not on sale. Let's just move on to this one actually. Ugh, the material on this is actually super duper high quality, I think. And you can totally wear this any way that you want to. You can wear this out or you can wear it at home while you're just lounging around. And the tag says puff sleeve V-neck sweater in goat. I don't know, I'm a little confused right now. This looks beige to me. Yeah, it says beige. I don't know what this goat wording on the tag is, but yeah. Last thing from Dynamite is this seamless bra top. This is really, really comfortable. I've worn this a couple times since I've gotten it, and I actually paired it with the chunky cardigan that I got from Misguided. Very cute outfit, I kid you not. This is also in the color beige, adjustable straps, padding in the boobage area. Very comfortable. Those are all the clothing items. I zipped through that pretty quick, I think, and Lincoln's still sleeping, so that is awesome. So I'm gonna show you guys what I got from Bath & Body Works. Like I said earlier, we were in partial lockdown, so non-essential services and non-essential products were not being sold in store. Bath & Body Works was still open, but they were only selling like hand sanitizers and hand soaps. Candles were not available. I did go onto their website though because I wanted candles, and I saw that they were having their semi-annual sale, so I got a total of 4 candles. The first one is this one, Frosted Spearmint, and when I buy candles, not only am I going for the scent, I'm also going for the package exterior. I want it to kind of match my home decor. It's not like absolutely essential that it has to match, but I would like it to match. Anyways, Frosted Spearmint, anything mint scented is just so refreshing and not overpowering. You know how some candles or scents can be just like super in your face, but this one is not, so that is a great thing. This one is also very refreshing scented. This is Fresh Balsam. The fragrance notes on this candle is woodland, balsam, crisp eucalyptus, fir branches, cedar wood with essential oils, and yeah, very refreshing. Oh, something spilled. Something spilled on this. I'm just noticing it now. It's on this candle too, what the heck? Is it you? Did you spill? Around the neck of the pump, it looks like it's cracked inside, so it probably dripped onto these. All right, anyways, not your problem. Next candle is Peach Bellini. This scent I've been buying since I was still living at my parents' house. I started buying Bath & Body Works candles probably when I was 19, 20, something like that. And this was always my go-to scent to buy and to burn. Like, it's Peach Bellini, enough said. This reminds me of my room at my parents' old house. Fragrance notes are succulent white peach, sparkling prosecco, sweet orange with essential oils. Very, very good scent. And the last candle is Pink Apple. Now, I know the color is very out there, but that's okay because it smells really good. I feel like this can potentially be an overpowering scent. It still smells really good. It smells like candy. Oh, yeah. very good. Pink apple punch. Fragrance notes are crisp apples, sun-kissed melon, sugar crystals with essential oils. Like, this smells good enough to eat. I'm serious. The hand soap that cracked, it's called Tis the Season, and it is a foaming hand soap. I'm probably gonna put this one out maybe into our guest bathroom. Red apple, ground cinnamon, and clove. Smells good. This hand soap is twisted peppermint, cool peppermint, sugared snow, and aromatic. Why can't I pronounce words today? Aromatic. Sure. This is just one of their regular hand soaps. It's not a foaming hand soap, nor does it have those beads in here. None of that. Just basic hand soap. And last hand soap is Winter Candy Apple. This is one of my go-to seasonal scents. Oh my gosh! Oh, Lincoln's awake. I can hear him. I better hurry up. Last thing from Bath & Body Works is this shower gel. I didn't open it yet, so I don't know how good it smells, because I've never actually gotten this scent before. But the fragrance notes are vanilla cashmere cream, caramel woods, and frosted clementine. That concludes my haul, you guys. Thanks for spending, 10-15 minutes of your time with me. I love filming haul videos. I think it's because I love watching them. If you stuck to the end of this video, you either love haul videos just as much as I do, or you just love watching me. I don't know, you tell me. If you did like this video though, thumbs up it, subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you next time. Bye!